All right, Mr. D, let's talk a little bit about insecticides.
Let's do.
And let's start by talking about Carbaryl.
Carbaryl, it's a carbamate, one naphtha methyl carbamate is what Carbaryl is, been around for a long time. Developed by, I think, Union Carbide in 1958.
Wow.
I was 3 years old.
Oh, how about that?
3 years old. I still remember.
You still remember?
Yeah.
How about that?
It is the third most used insecticide in the United States. The trade name was Sevin. For years and years, it was Sevin. And I found some Sevin somewhere a few years ago that wasn't Carbaryl. And I don't
really?
The nerve of them to do that.
But
anyway, it is most of the insecticides that I looked at were acetyl cholinesterase inhibitors, which is acetyl cholinesterase has something to do with the synapse, nerve endings, allowing nerve impulses to work, and it inhibits that. So basically, it inhibits the nervous system of these critters. And these things were derived from nerve gases.
Oh boy.
Developed by the military organizations.
Man. Wow.
But they're not the same thing.
Sure.
But it has the same mode of action. Acetylcholinase inhibitors. But it can be absorbed, you know, or you can ingest it. And so chewing insects, this is usually a pretty good product for chewing insects because they ingest it and then it does its thing. But very, very widely used insecticide. Insecticides are not immune to resistance. And I can remember back in my years as an extension agent, at one time, this was the most widely recommended product to use for flea control. And it got to the point where it took like 10 times more Carbaryl to kill a flea than it did when they originally started using it.
Right.
And so I don't even think you see this recommended for flea control anymore because I think fleas are pretty much resistant to it. It's not a restricted use pesticide. You know, you follow the label, and it will take care of still commonly recommended for a lot of the chewing insects. I think squash bugs
and
a lot of caterpillars that it'll work. It works on a lot of it works on the caterpillars that BT takes care of too, and so that's why it's important to identify the insects because you would much rather use Bacillus thuringiensis on a caterpillar that it's effective on than to use Sevin because it is a non-selective. It will kill, you know, just most insects, that including beneficials.
Right.
So
the bees
be careful
or
when
something
you use it.
Yeah, that comes to mind.
Right.
Right.
So be careful when you use it.
Yeah.
Follow the label and target, you know, the pest that you want to kill.
Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, please click the subscribe button below.